organization. Let's take a look what Game 3 has in store for us right now. RSM has actually just been adding a lot of gateways, as you guys can see. 6 gates going down on the left top side. DNS has his oracles. It's very important to keep those alive. I think Harson wants to be a little aggressive, James. I think it's time for you to bring back that hype cast.
I don't want you to do this to me.
But you'll have to wait about a minute.
I was going to say, like, there's nothing happening.
Just wait. That warp
prism, oh, the adept. Oh, no.
The warp prism is going to make its way to the other side of the map. And we're going to have a lot of Archons and Zealots. And if DNS is smart right now, James, you know what he does? He builds 17 shield batteries.
These are extremely similar builds, mate. It's a lot of gateways going down on the side of DNS as well.
And DNS really needs batteries, by the way, because like, he's been investing in all this other stuff, Stalkers early on, now Oracles. He's going to have less units, he's going to have less Archons.
Those stasis wards are in an interesting little spot as well.
And they're not going to stop a warp prism, James, unfortunately.
No, not really.
The bad part for DNS.
Yep, that warp prism's going to head down to the south. Try and find a little spot over there. There will be something that spots it, though, maybe, on that third. Oh, no, he's already warping in. Never mind.
Okay, that is not something I think DNS should be doing.
Yeah.
Even though Harsim is doing the same thing, I think Harsim is always going to attack DNS before DNS is going to attack Harsim. I don't know. Maybe this game will just go on. Maybe we'll have our first 4-5 base PvP. It's possible.
And you know what?
What?
The main game's ready, Rotterdam. I'm so sorry.
Well, we really did a good job hyping that one up, by the way.
One of the better death segments for this tournament so far.
Yeah, brilliant. Wardy added something quick. Thank you very much. All right, it's time to head over to the commentary team here for all the action for our next series. It's Pig and it's the Muslim.
Thank you so much. What a professional set of gentlemen over there preparing us for the match. I mean, what did you think about their insight? I mean, I was a bit of a crazy prediction, I think, for most of them.
Yeah, definitely. And also, I just love that segment, you know, getting into a game and it's like waiting for the hype and it's like, nothing's happening. They finish on Wardy. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to Special versus Hurricane. Like, I think Special is one of the players that will probably know Hurricane quite a bit more than most, given that he lives in Korea and stuff. Because Hurricane, he definitely flies under the radar. I know the people that lived in the foreign house definitely know him. People at home might have heard his name before, but honestly, I don't get to see or watch a lot of his games.
It's definitely the way it goes. If you're not practicing with him, you're not playing on that Korean ladder, you're not going to be competing against him as much. But I mean, they've lived together in the past in the foreign house and that sort of thing. Definitely going to be an interesting match here. I think Special does come in as the favorite. Hurricane, of course, managing to slide past Clem in a very close fought series earlier today, which was featured here on the mainstream. But I'm just excited. More PVT. It's one of my favorite matchups to watch right now. We're seeing an evolution in tactics on both sides. Special up against Hurricane. It's going to be awesome. Mexico versus Korea. Let's go into map number one.
And spawning over in the southeast side of Ephemeron, it is our blue Protoss, it is Hurricane.
And up here in the top left-hand side, in the red, the Mexican Terran player who's made such a name for himself in the past couple of years, he is Special.
And he truly is Special, Pig. Like, he's one of the guys, he's been around since the very start, and I know he's had multiple nicknames over the years, but ever since he rebranded as Special, he really has been just that. Like, I can always watch him.
Yeah.
Know he's going to bring something new and fresh to the table every time. He's got great multitasking, great skills, and he's so consistent these days. And right now, we're seeing something crazy from him right from the get-go.
You know, it's not Root Princess or Brittany anymore, for sure. Yeah. He's evolved. It's not even Major. It's Special. And as you said, he really is so consistent, so powerful an opponent. I think these guys have played a lot. Ben.
I can't believe that Hurricane's scouting like this around his map, because this is so unorthodox, but wow, he sees the barracks straight away, and this is where you want some of that SCV micro, some of the RNG to go in your favor. The SCV is on the other side now, so this is going pretty well for Special so far, but a lot comes down to whether he can get that barracks up or not, and right now, I think he's going to do it. That is really fortunate for him, but it's already a nice signifier by Hurricane, because now he could get that Cybercore up before his Nexus. Like, that could have really spiraled out of control.
Yeah, the early Reaper able to get quite a few probe snipes and put a lot of just pressure on the Protoss very early. Of course, Hurricane is going to be going for the quick Nexus behind it, as is standard. Players want to get that Nexus up. If they turtle up on one base, the Terran is very willing usually to just build a command center, get out a few tech units, and just kind of play a normal game. But the whole Protoss rhythm gets messed up. Here, with the expansion still down, That's going to be all about Hurricane trying to scout and figure out what is the follow-up from Special, exactly what are you committing to, and it's all going to be about Hurricane trying to block those forms of harassment that are going to come in.
And right now, the Zealot coming out early is really nice. If he didn't scout that barracks, he wouldn't have made that Zealot in the first place, but so far he's dealing with this perfectly, and it doesn't look like he's going to suffer any damage. A second Reaper being made by Special as well, so not just flying that barracks home, this is quite a bit of commitment by him. His CC obviously goes down much later, and we've got a Robo follow-up by Hurricane, so he's playing very safe and just respecting the possible follow-ups, such as Cloak Banshee, is it going to be like a Cyclone push or a Marine push afterwards, but no, it's just doing everything right.
It's a less flexible follow-up, the Robo, right? You can get observers out for vision, but you don't have things like oracles that can kind of scout and do pressure and harassment at the same time. It's more just, it's okay, I'm going to really push my probe count, and I'm going to force you to attack into me. Shield battery already going down, and it is a reactor on the factory. Two aliens now coming in for Special. Going to give him a lot of maneuverability. I wouldn't be surprised to see a medevac from that starport, but no, straight into the tech lab. So are you thinking Raven here, Banshee for follow-up harassment, or is it really just up to Special's feeling?
It's up to his feeling here. I mean, is he going to go more Hellions than just the two? Because, and yes, he is. So this is going to be one of those things where he hopes to use the Reapers to throw things out of place. If there is a wall being made, you get that Stalker out of position then, just try and run on through, but a Cloak being upgraded with a Banshee, this is full on harass. And it is, I mean, Hurricane's so well prepared, by the way. The fact that he got that early shield battery, he's got the observer out, maybe Special sees that little blur now, so he knows he's got like a little bit of a timing window. Ooh, okay, playing defensively with it.
Yeah, the observer is now going to continue, but I mean, I've got to emphasize that, Ben.
Is he going to dodge the observer with the Hellions?
They get spotted for sure. Quickly moving back there. The Reapers, though, coming in, denying that probe from putting down the third base. The Sentry, the Stalker, and the Zealot not in position, but there's a force field ready. Good pullback on the probes. Lovely force field.
That was really good. The Reapers trying to cause mayhem in the main base, which they're doing a little bit of that, but nice control. Oh my gosh!
No.
That was not meant to happen. These Hellions snuck right back in there and take out a lot of the probes. And that shield battery, even though it did quite a bit of healing, it can't avoid the one-shots of the 3-plus Hellions.
Indeed. Down to just 29 workers against Special's 31. The Banshee's going to come in behind that. As I was saying, before that got out of control, this is an insanely heavy commitment to this pressure. Stim, combat shields, the Marines, Marauders, Medivacs, the bio upgrades. That's not going to be hitting the field for many minutes in this game, so Special had to do damage here. This isn't the same as killing that number of workers with, say, a Widowmine drop, but it is still a very good start to the aggression ramping up here for Special. Going to trade the Banshee out for 3 more probes. Not the most amazing trade, but when Hurricane's economy is already so small, I think it becomes okay to lose a Banshee. Anything that stops Hurricane from getting his economy back up to a decent position is an all right trade.
I think that's a good point you make. Like, the fact that he did the damage earlier makes this trade also okay. Like, a Banshee 4-3 probes, in anybody's world, they're like, no way. But the fact that he killed 11 probes earlier, like, his strategy is about harassment. And now that he's going to get the Raven, he's playing very safe behind this, the third CC as well. Whoa, double Nexus?
Yeah.
I love that by Hurricane. The fact that he knows he's kind of behind because he suffered damage, he's like, well, I need to do something crazy. And very often we see players taking it safe while being just constantly behind and never getting ahead. I love this by Hurricane.
You got to just take those eggs, throw them all in one basket. And, you know, this is a perfect example of that. Fourth base going down, non-stop probe production as the focus, and just looking to defend with minimal units. And it's not just a crazy wild gamble where he's saying, oh, fingers crossed I don't get attacked for a long time. You know off this opening Special can't follow up with a bio attack. Hellions following up that early off the proxy racks, as well as, of course, the Banshees. This is a huge commitment from Special.
I wonder if Special sees that pylon and he's like, oh, is that just a scout pylon to see if I do like a drop down there? Or is he making a Nexus? So that's another thing that Special, you know, that is a bit of a gamble as to whether he knows what's going on behind there, because a Protoss taking a fourth base there when he's taken so much damage, that's unheard of.
If you knew this was happening right now, you definitely would want to do something to get on top of that.
And because it's so unordinary, the fact that he's sending over an SCV down there, just being like, do you actually have anything down there? Like, am I in for a weird game here? This could really signal that Special just goes into gear 6 and just absolutely massacres Hurricane, because Hurricane, make no mistake about it, he is playing with fire this game.
Yeah, Hurricane right now is saying, look, just give me another minute and a half, and then I'll make a ton of charge zealots and I'll be all fine. This push across the map, it's such a small set of units, but he knows there's no stim, and I think it's a great idea. Hurricane just looking to pin Special back on his side of the map with whatever he can. Four probes building at a time right now. Charge getting closer to finish. Six more gateways on the way, as well as the Templar Archives. And that is the best composition to just stop a relatively fast push. Zealots, Archons, it's a big, high damage army that's going to be really good for jumping on top of these siege tanks.
I love the fact that Hurricane's just been piling out four probes at a time. Yes, his economy's really good right now and Special. I love that also when he saw that fourth base, he's like, okay, I have to go. I have to punish this because this game could get out of control very fast. But ooh, this is very nice holding by Hurricane. Force fields in good positions and just picking off these range units, even pulled SCVs. He just has to buy time right now.
That last force field was brilliant. Really slowed down this advance here. The Prism's there to help evacuate, and it does get an interference matrix on it. But that means there's no Raven energy left. Zealots are now about to start warping in, seven or eight at a time, and those SCVs not going to be very useful against the Zealots. The Marine count has been whittled down quite a fair amount here. We're seeing Engineering Bays just to try and block the movement. A good Widowmine shot on one of the Zealots, but another Zealot split off. Does force a quick unburrow. Good reactions by Special, saving those Widowmine shots. He knows they're so important for holding off these Zealots.
Hurricane's so supply bot right now. Just pylons, just finishing, making three more, trying to cut off reinforcements where he can as well. But Special's got him in a really nice position here. Immortals dropped on the tanks, though, to deal with those. The War Prism's still alive, so he can save units by picking them up. And that's just what he does, but he loses it.
He steps forward and focus fires it with the Marines. A great movement there from Special. He senses weakness, he jumps on it, and that is gonna be it. Hurricane's fourth base gambit to try to get back in this game does not pay off. Special barely scouting the pylon with that Banshee, and you called it, Van. He immediately felt like there was something fishy going on here.
Oh, that was really good play. Like, you know, often we can look at the loser of a game and be like, man, why do you do that? But when you are behind, you have to take risks. And often you're left with five choices. They all feel like the wrong one, but it's about which one is the least wrong. I think it made sense why he went for that. And with the bridges and stuff, he could really slow down that push. And for a moment there, it looked like he could maybe just hold on. But Special, with the like, just, I see this, I have to do this. Like his knowledge, there was no thinking about it. It was just like, this is what I have to do to win this game.
Even the SCV pull there, 100% commitment from the Mexican player. Very cool and collected after that. A nice start for him as well. Definitely one that gets your Protoss opponent thinking about what's going to be coming in map two. A proxied barracks, two Reapers in your face early, a Fort Hellion run by, followed up by Cloak Banshees. Non-stop action from the get-go, and no space for the Protoss player to breathe.
That's what I love about Special, by the way. Like, he's got a huge array of builds, right? Like, he doesn't just... You barely ever see Special do the same thing, like, 10 times in a row. It'll be like, I can throw everything and anything at you. I can use Liberator as well. Heck, we could even see... Yeah. We've seen Ravens harassing in this matchup as well, and we're just like, what is he doing? And even though we're watching and we see everything coming into place, it's like, well, what else is going to come out of this guy? He's just crazy.
I mean, it's the secret to an incredibly powerful Terran player. The ability to just kind of use things that are going to keep their opponents off balance, make sure they don't know what's coming next. It's always a new timing attack. Sometimes it's the same attack, but you found a way to make it hit 30 seconds faster. It's these small edges, and Terran, as usually the aggressive race, the race that looks to make sure their opponent isn't getting out of control. You always need to add that depth to your play. TY, of course, his mentor, his friend who taught him a lot of builds back in the day, and has now, in many ways, as we've been talking about, been surpassed by Special himself in some of their matches.
it's hard to say he's been surpassed, right? I mean, TY
probably
is
not quite the right word, is it?
Like,
he beat him in a big tournament once.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, TY going up against Special, it's no longer a foregone conclusion, and that's awesome. Special, he's definitely more rounded out than he used to be, though, right? Like, he used to be a little bit sloppy in parts, but I feel that, like, his micro held him back for a while, but he's obviously improved in a lot of ways. And throwing buildings into the mix as well, when you're doing, like, a push, you just see a random engineering bay going up, but it does make things way more difficult. So he utilizes the whole Terran arsenal, which absolutely makes him very, very dangerous and difficult to play against.
Yep, I can recall those old days of Special or Major throwing harassment from every side all game long. And many Banshees walking into cannons and drops kind of unloading into spines and spores and things, because he was always focused on hitting his macro perfectly and micro kind of came secondary. I think he's found a much better balance of that, the current iteration of SpeCial, able to balance between it all. I think going into map two, it's a tough call for Hurricane. How exactly do you adapt and adjust? Of course, just a very small delay due to a technical issue where we'll be getting into it in just one moment. And for now, SpeCial, I mean, he's just been very focused so far. It's looking good.
You know, when I think about everything that went right for Hurricane that game, though, like, he scouts the barracks at the start. He then also has, like, and he takes no damage to the first two Reapers, which, you know, that's not the biggest deal, but it's nice that you scouted it in the first place and just didn't take damage. But then he also saw the Hellions moving across the map with his Observer, and the fact that he still lost 11 to 12 probes, like, he could have definitely handled that better, because when those probes ran back in and then that one shot of all the Hellions dealing those, Hurricane, going into the next game, he just has to be like, okay, I can't get flustered. I can't take too much damage. Yes, this game I fell really far behind early on, but the fact is he made a lot of right choices after the chaos happened. So Hurricane just needs to keep calm, keep focused, and just scout and assess what's really going on.
Indeed. Going to be going into that one. And it's always tough here, but remember, guys, this is the upper bracket, so both players do have a life to spare at this point. We'll be going down to the loser's match, the one who does fall down, and they've got another chance there.
They do have a life to spare, but winning this would mean they go straight into the group stage, which is such a big deal for both of these guys. I mean, that's a guaranteed at least $2.4K, and
a lot more series to show your work as well, right?
A lot
so
more.
Many.
Like, this is still the offline qualifier, I suppose. And both these guys, they traveled a long way to get here. I believe they both are staying in Korea right now. And you don't come to Katowice, if you're SpeCial or Hurricane, just to get knocked out of the bracket. You come to make it pretty far.
Yeah, I mean, Hurricane's been looking so serious on camera, even after beating Clem. And in that interview with Smex, he was very collected and kind of just, you can tell, eye on the prize right now. There's no getting excited over a single map victory or anything like that. Sometimes you've got to aerate the brain, as you can see there from SpeCial, that technique, just kind of keeping it going.
I was just thinking about last year when SpeCial was actually here. He was in the group with the five Protosses as well.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
He almost made it out. Like, I remember he took maps of stats and such. I think he finished with like a 2-3 score, if I remember correctly. But yeah, he has notoriously done pretty well in Katowice. And every tournament I feel SpeCial goes into, he does better the year after. Like, it takes him a little bit of a slow build-up when he gets to the quarters.
Yeah.
The next year, it's like down to the semis, and then boom, up in the finals like he was in the WCS last year. You don't go into a tournament looking to do worse than you did last time. So I feel that he's got a bit of fire in him. It really feels like he's a lot cleaner a player than he was back then.
And I think it was especially in the early rounds of the tournament, right? We talk about Terran players trying to surprise their opponents. And I think in the early rounds, SpeCial's builds are fresh. The players haven't seen them. He also doesn't feel the pressure to necessarily change them up. As he gets deeper in this tournament, as we see more of a stretch between the rounds, he's going to be very aware of the fact that players have studied what he's done in the early rounds. He's going to be looking to work in new variations. But here he can kind of go, you know what? I've hidden plenty of build orders in practice. I know how I want to play the maps, the series. And he can, to some extent, almost just play the race as much as the player. He doesn't need to kind of overthink, variation in his play in terms of digging up new ways of making his old builds fresh. And I think the deeper you get in a bracket, that's one of the hard things. As a Terran player, you get to the semis, you get to the grand finals, and your opponent has so much info on how you're playing that tournament.
And you know, in SpeCial's play, it really feels like he doesn't struggle with coming up with new stuff either. Like a little twist here, an extra unit there, and he just seems to make magic absolutely happen. But guys, we will be loading up into the game immediately now, and the second map will be on Eternal Empire, and spawning in the top right, it is Hurricane.
Down here in the bottom left-hand side of this large map, the Red Terran player. He's, of course, hailing from Mexico and looking for a championship to hold up. He is the Red Terran SpeCial.
He really is, like, the foreign hope of Terran. I know we've had, like, other players Hero Marines obviously come on leaps and bounds recently, so consistent and strong. Euthermal has had really high peaks and, you know, some little slumps here and there, but he's looking really strong here. But Special has really been holding up the flag for us foreign Terrans recently. And going up against Hurricane, that is definitely a doable match, because I don't think anybody would really class Hurricane as the favorite here. I know a few people might be like, well, Protoss is really good against Terran, man, but Special's just really good. And the fact he can do a build like that where it gets scouted and seemingly, you know, Hurricane knows everything that's going on, he can still get damage done. And that's the thing that really impresses me about Special.
There's going to be a reasonably early scout. Once again, checking the third base for a proxy barracks is Hurricane. Going to get over here and confirm that indeed it is just a barracks first opening for a Special.
Oh, so it was barracks first gas, right? And then it was a marine build.
Ooh.
So this is already a little bit cheeky, a little bit sneaky. I'm not sure why he's doing this, because this means he won't be able to scout with a Reaper unless he makes it sometime later in the game.
Can you just hit like a faster Widowmine drop just because the factory's a few seconds faster, the starport's a few seconds faster with this?
So I'm actually unsure. So if you go gas first and then Reaper, you still get your factory about the same time as doing this. So it is definitely unusual to me. Obviously, you'd have more minerals because you get the gas later and such, but this already is a bit odd, I feel. Maybe he feels it's not a map that he needs to scout on with a Reaper and such. Maybe just the distance of the map, given it is one of the largest maps, makes him feel a bit less scared about like the arrival of timings and such. But yeah, already interesting to see some deviation from Special.
Yeah, I mean, I like the extra minerals there in case you feel you do need to put a bunker down. I feel like gas first, always a bit awkward defending a really quick adept coming across the map. Maybe not as such a big concern on this map here, since it is quite a long path across. Interestingly, Hurricane actually is going to be going sentry next and into Robo. So it's looking like I wouldn't be surprised to see a two-base Colossus opening.
I tell you what though, getting that barracks first and then the like Marines, so the Marines got less build time, right, than the Reaper. This is the fastest reactor you can get. So these might be the fastest reacted Hellions you can get across the map while still being relatively safe. And given how successful the Hellions were in the first game, I'm not surprised that Special's doing this. And look, this is a pretty technical build with the amount of swapping and shimmying about that he's been doing. So these Hellions are going to arrive very early. And the fact that Hurricane hasn't seen a Reaper either, this could actually catch him totally off guard.
Oh, that adept's very far to the left. I mean, the sentry is nice with the force field. A stalker did just come out, and it's going to come down to the front, but that adept being out of position is huge. Oh, no, only one stalker. It can't do a lot of damage to these.
Oh, and these two Hellions, this is already more than you think you'd get with them. Oh, no!
Oh, a disaster there for Hurricane, already losing six probes. And remember, it's not just six probes, it's six probes this early in the game. That's the first two Hellions. And as you said, Demuslim, very, very, very early Hellions as well. Interesting cancel on the Banshee there.
Yeah, certainly is. Like, is he looking to fake out here? Like, he's continuing with the cloak. So I think he's keeping the cloak while this Phoenix comes along, just hoping that his opponent makes an observer later on. So this hallucination, as soon as it's gone, I think, boom, we're going to see the cloak cancelled here. And bah, that's exactly what happens. Third CC starts. Special's playing mind games, and he's absolutely playing his opponent.
I guess that's seeing the Robo as well. He saw not only the hallucination, knew that was going to come across with the sentry, but he also saw the Robo. So detection easily accessible. Shield battery comes out. Observers being forced out. We might see Hurricane keeping a few more of those observers at home now that he does feel the threat of the imagined Banshees on the map.
This is a cheeky drop, by the way, with the War Prism. I mean, such a random little squad, right? An Immortal, a Sentry, an Adept. I'm not really sure what he hopes to get done. Obviously, it's going to be a little bit of an SCV damage if he does get in, but Special's more than prepared for this. Like, his play so far, the Hellions not only dealing damage, but getting a good scout off against his opponent. And man, he's more than ready for this.
Good pullback there. That Raven just hit Interference Matrix Energy right now. So can obviously lock down that Prism, stop it from picking up units.
Pig, look at this. There's like no third Nexus going up. He starts his third and fourth gas with a Twilight Council and a Forge. Like, this is just very unusual play.
Yeah, this is definitely, I mean, Hurricane showed some unusual openings against Clem, often going for that six-gate charge lot Blinkstalker with no upgrades before the third base, really looking for the aggressive potential and doing big zealot timing attacks. So Hurricane here, I think he's just been so traumatized by those fast Terran pushes. He's looking to really be ready and on top of them. Fast attack, faster upgrades, and he feels more comfortable when he's pressuring his opponents. Even when he's just out here with this Prism, it feels like he's more able to control the pace of the game. That Widowmine reposition, but good reaction by Hurricane. His eyes are open, he's watching.
He certainly is. These, like, this little group is being problematic. Oh, these are nice force fields. Can get quite a few of the SCVs and just deny mining for quite some time. But these tanks were nicely placed, so Hurricane can't commit too hard. On the other side of the map, we do have a Raven flying in to do some harass, and also, more importantly, to scout this third basin when it's being finished. And Special, upon seeing that, he's going to be like, wow, I'm actually pretty darn far ahead, unless you're doing something super-duper cheeky this game, such as going for maybe incredibly fast Storm here. And that's exactly what Hurricane's doing.
And then he cancels it. What? Shows it? I think that's because the scan was down.
So mind game galore here from both.
And then goes Colossus, I guess, the Robo Bay, maybe Disruptors as well. Yeah, really trying to be tricky, but it's a hard position. I mean, we were talking about how earlier in the Clem game as well, you know, with a similar late third, it's very awkward when you're even in workers, when you're down in workers versus a Terran player. Over time, they are going to get so much stuff out on the map, and Special 1-1 is about to finish. Stim about to finish. Medivac's out on the map. He's got the mobile army, the scary army that can start pressuring his opponent. The Raven continuing to be a nuisance up here. I'd love to see Special just send that home. I think it is a really fantastic resource for later in this game.
Oh, he's got a little bit of an opening here, and I mean, it feels like Hurricane can collapse on this, though, pretty hard. Special just going in for the Stalkers there, the probes at the natural as well, taking out all these Stalkers on the high ground. Blink was not available, a force field trying to get him away, but probes, they are being hunted by this little squad of Marines, and all of a sudden, 14 probes lost. I think the Ravens, wow, even at the third base, killing probes there.
Yeah, double auto turret, I think, did go down on that third mineral line at the same time. Beautiful syncing up of that, the Raven. It was just luring those units over to the third. The Bio stimmed on in. Special already up on workers before that started, is now up 20 workers. The Raven even surviving. Oh man, he's just toying with Hurricane right now. That Raven, such a pain in the butt.
Special's playing incredibly good, and he's not missing a beat back home either. Gets a sensor tower up just to be safe at his third base. He's getting plus two weapons as well. It's not very often you see a Terran quite far ahead in upgrades against a Protoss, but also look at the supply here, Pig. 67 workers, a bigger army as well against the 50 workers of Hurricane. Hurricane, he has been absolutely destroyed economically, and Special's feeling comfortable and feeling safe to boot.
Viking harass going into the natural at the same time as the new army pushes towards the third base. Ooh. That Viking picking off a handful of probes. It's going to take out a Stalker. The army moves to respond. He comes in and clicks on the Nexus. Goodbye, third base.
I can't believe he is just attacking with everything that he has. He had a Viking randomly at the natural there that lulled him away. These Immortals as well, they're all going to fall down against this army, and you can't afford to lose those when you've just lost your third base. And Special, he just presses on the lead that he has. He continues to make Hurricane's life so difficult, and GG Special takes it rather swiftly and rather convincingly.
That was just smashing through of this bracket from Special. We saw Sue do it just before as well, and now Special does just crush through the bracket, smashes Hurricane, and does claim his place in that top 24 group stage. A few thousand dollars and a spot in the round robin matches. I mean, that's well deserved. Special really didn't have to break a sweat in that series.